Yeah, so here goes. There's another one with them just like, the flower report. So what I'm trying to deal with this particular saga of life as a flower, the flower itself, its expectations, its dramas, its reactions. Before I can get all like, oh yes, and the flower is doing this because of a lot of it's gonna head back to science, and we're gonna go, well, the flower is only making decisions and choices based upon the alkalinity in the soil, just little bits of extra minerals here and there. So that would be like the personality change in the flower. So the flower is like, well, it's the risk taker flower, because we're all excited about the risk taker. Now, I have two dilemmas with the risk taker. Is it really the risk taker, the one that is at the edge? Here we have a group of flowers, they're all the same. Now, on the edge, the ones that are out there at the edge, before, you know, the ones that have their faces away from all the others, actually. They don't have anybody in front. Now, are they the leaders? You know, we have to look at that right away. Are those flowers, those ones that don't have another flower in front, they only have the flowers behind them? You have to really put yourself into, well, if it's a meditation for you, I guess it can be. But if the flowers are all behind you, and you're the flower in front, then are you the leader flower? Are you the leader? We all want to say, yes, you are the leader, because all the other flowers are behind you, essentially rooted and walking, but they're rooted behind you. So that's like your populous occasion. So here you got, but in a way, another way you can also look at it is a musk ox moment, where you have the parentals, which is similar to the leaders also. You have the parentals that are surrounding the core, the heart of the flowers. So they could be the great protectors. The wall of protection. So, I mean, obviously they are in a different developed state than the ones behind. Because the ones behind, they have, oh, okay, there's one over there, and I mean, yeah, they'd say they, you know, if you want to say they have eyes, but yeah, they have those types of eyes that they know with their feelers, they know that there's no flower in front, or they know that there is a flower in front. You know, so it creates a different flower. And I know I can look at one flower and go, my God, that one is so sexy. And I can look at another flower and go, that one is distressed, absolutely distressed. You know what I'm saying? And it'll just be like, what happened? What happened? So we'll go and attribute it to the soil. We'll attribute it to it, what it's been nourished with. So it's been nourished with something that makes it distressed, and another has been nourished with something that makes it extra sexy. But you can see those differences just in a photograph of the same group. So it's very, very tiny. It's a very, very tiny change. Very, very tiny change. So yeah. So now I'm looking at this risk taker. The risk taker is on the outside. Or it's the parental, the musk ox, you know, where they surround the children. They put the young musk ox in the center. Okay, so round, surround, 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 you know, to save it. But that falls apart. That falls apart as soon as a little dog, who really a little dog in nature, who is the happiest when he's off leash, runs into the middle of those flowers to fertilize. So the little dog is running into the center of that occasion. Okay? So he's not really, you know, So if anything, he's going to tromp on those little tiny ones in the middle. He could damage them. But it's almost like it's a core feeder. You know, you look at the dog, you look at the cat, they're core feeders. They're feeding the core of that flower group. You know, spread it out. So we have so many deductions you can start to make with the one grouping of flowers, whether it's daisies or daffodils, whatever. That when, you know, when they're all just they're expansion flower. You know, their group is expanding, and how it's expanding. So we can look right away at the attraction element. The attraction element from one flower to another, to a dog, to a bird. Now, when you say a bird, okay, so here's the bird. He makes a decision. He swoops in. The bird swoops in, and it's the time when they're just picking the seeds out. Now, the location that flower is a real, it has to have a real certain meaning, otherwise the bird wouldn't have gone there. So where they are raised, where that flower is raised at that location, he goes in there, he grabs those seeds. Now he can take one seed, two seed, he can take all of those seeds, and he can fly miles. He can fly 100 miles away. Or he can just go over into the next field, or just stay right there for a few days. So all of these decisions, we're like, okay, well, who's making the decision of how far the bird is going to go now? Now that he's ingested the seed of the flower to propagate for the next season. So I know, it's not as swell as I wanted it to be, this video, but yeah. So the bird is out there. It's taking that extra, the extraordinary extra journey. So because we all want to know how come at that moment, you know, he's attracted to that flower. Attracted to that dried out flower and the seeds to go that extra journey versus the one and that is just going to stay there. And so when you look at people, oh, it's so easy to fun to look at people and look at it the same way. You know, you have a group of people and they just never move anywhere. They don't go anywhere. They don't go on airplanes. The people just stay in one situated area. They don't travel. And then you'll have one or two over there that's it. They go. And they go far. Some of them will go all the way to Tibet. Now the same can happen to a seed of a flower. The exact same. So we're looking at that type of travel that can happen from a little tiny plant. You know, it's, we'll call it a directive. You know, we can't actually say in all certainty that that's just a scientific event, that's just the bird was hungry and it went out on a big flight. That was it. You can't just say that. There could have actually been more, you understand, much more beyond that event. I mean, much more that actually propagated it to fruition. Okay, so now I'm looking out already at the risk taker ones. I'll call them the risk taker, even if they're a parental musk ox flower, even if they are the risk taker that's just out there, that just doesn't want to see any others in front. Whenever I grow, I don't want to see any other flowers in front of me. You know, it's a very, very human trait, isn't it? So we're like, okay, so there's the flower. You know, the one that's out there, doesn't want to see any other flowers in front, has a higher potential a higher potential to travel further, to be eaten, to be taken by a fox, to be taken miles and miles and miles away. It has a higher potential. I'm not sure why a fox wants to eat it, but we'll say something else. We'll say a bird or something. Yeah, we'll say a bird. So the bird wants to take that those seeds and then fly. So because that happens, we're not going to see the ones hovering in the middle. Those flowers hovering in the middle. We're not going to see them with big, hey, 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 I want to go to Tibet. They're not going to be waving their hands as high unless for some reason you notice, well, wait a minute, those ones are taller. Those ones are absolutely taller in the middle. All of a sudden there's a few that just decided to spring up. Maybe that is their leader moment. They're like, hey, look at me, I want to get out of here. Maybe that's their leader moment also. They want to travel. They want to propagate away. So yeah, you can look at that. Like, and oddly, sometimes when a flower or a plant grows too tall, too fast, it is stressed. It's in a stress situation anyway. So it's almost like that waving its hand at the sea as it's sinking and drowning. A moment, you know, hurry, 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 I've got to get out to another pasture, another meadow, so I can survive in the next life much better than in this. Okay, so now I have the flower, now it's making decisions for the next life. Okay, so we're talking about reincarnation. So that little flower is making big decisions. It's growing as tall as it can be because it already knows that it doesn't have maybe the greatest soil. It just wants to get out of there. Maybe it's too crowded. So it's too crowded. So next life. So its big agenda is if I can just be selected. I need to be selected by something from the animal kingdom. Yeah, something from the animal kingdom, so I can get out of here and I can grow. I can grow in a non-crowded situation. I can grow in the most fertile fields, you know, because it will go through the digestion system. It'll have all of that going on for it. So yeah. So even in that, when you see those plants that are like kind of weak and leggy and tall, when you see them crammed together, you have to maybe think, well, Its objective at that moment is not to just die, it's to actually get out, be seen, and get out of there. So yeah, start thinking about all of these things that a plant has motives. Plant has motives, and a plant has agendas. It has reasons to just not stay there sometimes. And then there are others that are just so content. There are others that are so content and they will just stay there in their one little spots. but when I was thinking about the periphery ones, the risk takers, we'll go back to them again. Oddly, they will receive more alkaline. They'll receive more alkaline from animals. More alkaline from pets. Now, that's just because when a dog walks by, even if it's nature and he doesn't have a leash on, a dog walks by, chances are he's just going to lift his leg and keep going. They're not always going to rush into the center in that situation. When they're lifting their leg, they don't normally go into the center. So we often find with, and they do use it for the marking of the trails. So you see all of these animals having the markings of their trails along the edges of the flowers. And so you have the higher concentration of the alkaline soils. So because you have this higher concentration of alkaline soils, does that mean, everybody, we can relegate alkaline as the big risk taker? The alkaline medium as being a person that is predisposed to being able to have higher risks. That would be a fun one. That would be a fun one to find out, yeah. So if we have a higher alkaline level, alkalinity level, chances are we could be more isolated and happy about it. Be more of a leader and happy about it. Not have to be a follower and be happy about it. Okay, so we have all of these things going on with this alkaline extra. So there could be an alkaline component there that is kicking us up and giving us this extra potential for muskox, the extra potential for leadership, the extra potential of the risk, you know, to be out there in the path, the extra potential, you know. So, it's kind of a fun thing, but yeah, but when we're looking at science itself, it's science is going to want to get to everything, and it's going to want to every little tiny little organism, every tiny little element of study of that flower in the front that only has maybe one over here on the right, maybe has one over there back there on the left. That one in the front versus all those other ones that have, oh my gosh, I have like 7, 8 friends. You know, 7 or 8 friends. I have this network of friends, you know. And then there's those ones in the front. It's like, well, I don't really need that many. I don't really need that many. I have other things to do. So when we're looking at that, we're like, well, how many conversations are going on here in this patch of flowers? How many conversations? And how human is it, you know, what you think or what you perceive being a human and your capabilities and your reasonings and your thoughts, what makes it so difficult to flip the cookie and go, well, wait a minute, maybe they're making the exact same decisions or making those exact same, no, you know. I'm just not a networker. I don't need to have 7 or 8 friends. You know, I'm very happy to be a leader with the shiny flower in the front. And I know that flower I put up yesterday, I guess it was too bright. You know, it was too bright. And it just shows everything. And it's just like, you know, you do something like that, it's even like the flower itself is trying to teach you. It's like, well, you know, maybe it's impatient, maybe you're impatient as the photographer. Maybe you're impatient because you didn't even use the what do we call it, the photography material equipment here to make it more beautiful. Yeah, so there's always these lessons you can learn even from taking a photo with a plant. I learn a lot of lessons from taking photos of plants. And yeah, sometimes, oh, they're just like, hurry and fix me and make me better. but what I really was thinking about was that personality. Those personality mixes that start to happen, and you can see that with human beings. You can see that with human beings. Like there'll be one who has to talk all the time. Has to talk all the time and is very communicative. All right, so that person, that type of flower needs to, maybe is really used to being next to a whole bunch of other flowers, and just that is a comfort factor. You know, they're more comfortable there. So in that particular lifetime of that flower, if it's somehow uprooted and you move it over there, you know, chances are it's maybe not going to even survive. A lot of times we're looking at taking a flower and transplanting it. The ones in the middle all clusterly, if you want to do a science experiment, probably won't be so happy as the one that has been a leader, the one that has been used to being alone, used to being by himself or herself. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. big adaptation change. You know. So that's all. That's all. There's so much I was. I don't know. I'm missing my fun. Missing my fun. Anyhoot. Yeah. What was it? Yeah, this is so science-y, isn't it? And I didn't really want to be a science teacher. But I guess the flower itself and the proof of it, and I guess I still have to go back and look at science and look at things like alkalinity and acids in the soil. You know, and then, you know, you just look at each other. We just look at each other as human beings, as walking flowers. All of us walking, talking flowers. That's another, I don't know. That's a hard reach for some of you, I know that, but walking, talking flowers I don't know, they have a, I don't know, it was funner before. It was funner before this video. So yeah. When I think about the brain, when we're getting into the single cell organism, when we're getting into the multiple celled organism, we're getting into when the brains actually begin the actual process of thought and consciousness. Yeah, when consciousness and conscious thought is just making decisions. Because nature isn't perfect. Nature isn't perfect at all. And you know, we can look at this beautiful patch of flowers and go, oh, they look the same. They all look exactly the same. But in reality, you know, if you put yourself there and you really get into it, it's like, no, that one does not look the same as this one over there. No, nothing like me. That one has a little rosier face. Or over here, that one is more bleached out. No, we're not the same at all. And that one's a little smaller, and this one's a little fatter. And how come, maybe we don't witness that on a human scale, but the flowers themselves maybe can very well differentiate that between each other. Yeah, well, that one just eats a lot. They have a huge portion of a fattener, and some petals are fatter on that flower, and that one over there, some petals are just thinner. And so we look at humans, and I'm like, well, gosh dang it, they're just going to solve it, aren't they? And it's just going to be like, we're going to take this little amino pill or something. They're just going to solve it. We're going to just be what? Turned into, like, for sure you don't eat too much, and for sure you don't get too thin, or for sure you don't get too fat, and your skin is just right, and this la 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 is everything is so perfect. I guess that'll be the goal. That will be the goal. But I think you're going to have to look at flowers, you're going to have to look at those types of organisms first before you start looking at humans. You have to look at the flowers and at their beginnings and how they're responding with each other. How the flowers are responding with each other. Yeah. Anyway, I'm tired tonight. That's all.